And a very good day to each and every one of you. Time now for weather news today with J7409. The name you know, the news you can use. And today, of course, Tuesday, the 12th of June, 2018. Before we get going, if any of you guys anywhere have any weather pictures or sky pictures that you'd like to share with us, we'd love to see them. I'd love to share them. Please click Show More, scroll down, and you will find an email address to send them to. And if it's your first time here and you're into the weather like all the rest of us, well, please subscribe, click the bell, check off the email notifications, make sure all is checked to make sure that you get all the latest in weather news, forecast alerts, and tropical weather. Well, we'll get on with it. I'm going to put the tropical weather into the regular weather forecast for today. Got things to do. And right now, this morning, as we look at Bud, well, Bud is a Category 4 hurricane. Now, the winds of Bud are 130 miles per hour. The minimum central pressure, 948 millibars. If you are tracking Bud, it's located at 18.1 north, 108.2 west. Bud is moving at 7 miles per hour. Bud is moving at 7 miles per hour to the north-northwest, right up towards the peninsula area here. And as you can see, Alida is no longer here. When we take a quick look at the tracking chart from the National Hurricane Center this morning, X marks the spot where Bud should be about 3 a.m. earlier this morning. Still a major hurricane. Bud should lose a little of the wind and turn into just a Category 1 or 2 hurricane by around 12 p.m. lunchtime tomorrow and remain that way through Thursday. Now by Friday, a strong tropical storm as it heads toward the Baja Peninsula, and then after passing over the peninsula, be a tropical depression and keep weakening as it moves to the north. Now, everybody in this area, as I've been telling you, you need to make sure that you are prepared for a lot of rain, surf, and some wind. But you see the strength of it. It's not going to be a major hurricane or either a hurricane, but it will be a pretty good tropical storm probably by the time it gets down in this area. Then it will disintegrate as it keeps moving up. But you're still going to get some rain and some wind with this system. So be prepared. Now, so far as the watches and the warnings go, they've changed somewhat since yesterday. Interest in southern Baja California Sur, Mexico should monitor the progress of Bud, okay? Bud does have maximum sustained winds of near 130 miles per hour with higher gust. And, of course, that's a lot of wind, folks. You got to be prepared for it. Bud is a Category 4 hurricane, and it should weaken like it just showed on the map, and it should begin to weaken a little later on today and continue through Thursday while Bud approaches the southern Baja California area. Now, Bud is forecast to weaken below hurricane intensity by tomorrow night. Hurricane force winds extend outward up to 30 miles from the center, and tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 115 miles, and the barometric pressure is 28.00. Now, affecting land, well, this is what you're going to get, the rain. Rainfall, Bud is expected to produce total rain accumulations of 3 to 6 inches across much of southwestern Mexico, with isolated maximum amounts of 10 inches through Thursday. So you guys need to be prepared for the rain. Now, of course, these rains can cause flash floods and mudslides and all of this stuff. So please be aware. So far as the surf goes, Well, Bud's going to continue to affect portions of the coast and southwestern parts of Mexico during the next few days, and it will begin to affect the southern Baja California Peninsula later today. Now, these swells are likely to cause life-threatening surf and rip currents, so please be advised of that. Now, what's going on with our little lakes over here this morning? Well, just about the same as yesterday. I really don't think it's going to do anything, and I haven't all along. But I could be wrong. If I am, I'll put it up. But if it looks like it's still the same thing that I thought, I'm going to put it up too. So here we go. A large area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms over the Western Caribbean Sea. It's associated with a trough of low pressure. Now, this area of disturbed weather is expected to move westward to northwestward over the Central America and the Yucatan Peninsula during the next couple of days. A little, that's what they got, and little, if any, development is expected during that time. Now, environmental conditions could become slightly conducive for some development when the system moves into the southwestern Gulf of Mexico by the end of the week. Regardless of development, this disturbance will likely produce locally heavy rainfall across portions of Nicaragua, Honduras, Belize, Guatemala, and the Yucatan Peninsula through Thursday. 10% chance of forming in the next 2 days, 20% chance of forming to anything tropical in the next 5 days. But like I say, I will keep my eyes on it. Anything changing? I do think that once it does get up in here, it's got such a tight gradient to it with the isobars. It might try to turn into something tropical, like either a disturbance or maybe a tropical storm, but I really don't think it'll get up to a tropical storm category. It might. We got to watch the trade winds on it. So, other than that, that's what's going on with it. Don't worry, I'll keep my eyes on it. And for the weather in general, we're going to get to that right now. Here's a shot of the GFS, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. Boy, oh boy, I had storms all day and half the night yesterday with hail, very heavy drenching, downpouring rain. We had some winds. We had little tornadoes all around the area, but thank good Lord I didn't have one myself or a waterspout, but they were like all around me. I know this weather's been very hectic for many of you. Will it continue? Well, let's turn on the GFS and see what everything is looking like for this morning. Okay, here we go. Scattered to widespread thunderstorms can be expected along and east of an area of low pressure and associated cold front that's moving through the central United States. This frontal boundary, along with moisture feeding north from the Gulf of Mexico, will be the focus for continued convection over the next couple of days. Now, the forecast shows 1 to 3 inches of rain through tomorrow for the Ohio Valley, although locally higher amounts will be possible. Also, there's a slight risk of severe storms for much of the Central Plains today, and from eastern Ohio, West Virginia, to upstate New York for tomorrow. Now, there's an enhanced risk of severe weather that encompasses most of the North Dakota area and Northwest Minnesota area on Thursday, a threat for tornadoes. Large hail and strong winds will be present in addition to flash flooding for the described areas I've just said. Also, high pressure will continue to settle southward along the mid-Atlantic coast through tomorrow before weakening and reinforcing further to the north by tomorrow. While temperatures are forecast to remain 5 to 10 degrees below average for the mid-Atlantic region, For today, high temperatures should rise a bit above average for portions of the mid-Atlantic region, with some 90s expected. High pressure building in over the Pacific Northwest and Intermountain region will result in a warming trend through the middle of the week, along with mostly dry conditions. Afternoon temperatures from Montana into Idaho will range from the 70s to 90s, which is roughly around 10 degrees above mid-June averages. Light rain will begin moving into the Pacific Northwest late this afternoon and then into tomorrow as a Pacific front approaches the coast. And that's what it's looking like today, folks, for your weather in general, as well as the tropical update as of now. I'll be back later this afternoon, have all the updates for you. There is this possibility of severe weather breaking out across the U.S. today. Please keep your eyes on the sky and be aware of your skies and what's happening. When these storms pop up, it's very quick. They can be very dangerous. They most of the time do contain hail, high winds, anywhere from 40 to 60 miles per hour, and they are capable of producing tornadoes. So just keep your eyes on thing and your ears open, okay? I love you guys. Please subscribe. I love you so much. Thank you for your comments, your likes, your sharing the video to help me to keep others aware and safe. Everybody have a wonderful day. Peace, love, and kindness to each of you.